Okay, students, so today let us take up one more topic. This I have covered in online class, but let me record it and send so that whenever you want, you can just have a revision, because subtractor is also very important. When you look at your previous A question papers, subtractor, full subtractor questions, you can find in many question papers. So please concentrate. And many of you had doubt in writing the truth table of subtractor. So let me explain the design of half subtractor as well as full subtractor. So this is one more example of combinational logic circuit. As we have discussed many circuits, like encoders, decoders, multiplexers, then comparators, right? Then adders, adders, correct? So same way, we have subtractor also. Adders, we have discussed parallel adder, look ahead, carry adder, and all. Subtractor, you have only half subtractor and full subtractor. So just like half adder, half subtractor, you will have two inputs, one bit, two numbers, each number is of one bit. And adder, how many outputs? We have two outputs, sum and carry. Here also, same way, we have borrow and difference. Or you can write it as difference and borrow. Anything, whichever way you want. I have written borrow first and then the difference. You can write difference and then the borrow, like how we write sum and carry in adder. So now, two numbers, each number is of one bit. So which are the possible combinations? 00, 01, 10, 11. Okay? So how do we write the subtractor truth table? See, what is this? This is 0. Just assume that this is a decimal number. 0 minus 0 is what? Normal addition. 0 minus 0 is what? 0. 0 minus 0 is 0. How do we represent 0 in binary? 0, 0. How do we represent 0? See, 0 minus 0 is 0. I am taking this as a normal decimal number. 0 minus 0 is 0. How do we represent 0 in binary? 0, 0, 2 bit. 0, 0. So this will be difference. 0, 0, this will be difference and this will be borrow. Okay, so what is borrow? Borrow is 0. What is difference? Difference is also 0. Okay, next, coming to the second case. 0 minus 1 is what? Normal addition. What is 0 minus 1? Minus 1. 0 minus 1 is minus 1, correct? Minus 1. How do we represent minus 1 in binary? We have to consider the 2's complement of 1. 2's complement of 1. So to represent minus 1 in binary, 2's complement of 1. How do we represent 1 in binary? 0, 1. How do you take 2's complement of this? 1's complement plus 1. 1's complement is what? 1, 0. Wherever you have 0, 1. 1, 0. That is what is 1's complement. Add 1. That will give you the 2's complement. 0 plus 1, 1. 1. So minus 1 in binary is represented like this. Minus 1 in binary, to represent minus 1 in binary, first you write the binary value for 1. 0, 1. Take 1's complement. So this is 1's complement of 1. Add 1. This will be 2's complement. Am I correct? So what is this? This is difference and this is borrow. This is difference and this is borrow. So what is borrow? Borrow is 1. What is difference? Difference is 1. Correct? Now, third case. 1 minus 0. What is 1 minus 0? 1. How do you represent 1 in binary? 0, 1. So this is borrow. This is difference. So what is borrow? 0. Difference is 1. If you are writing difference first, then borrow, you have to be very careful. Okay, you have to write this difference. This will be borrow. Okay, that is why I am stressing more on which is borrow, which is difference. Okay, next, 1 minus 1 is what? 0. 1 minus 1 is 0. How do you represent 0 in binary? 0, 0. This is borrow, this is difference. 0, 0. That's all. Okay, so now after we write the truth table, you know how to design the circuit. It's a very simple circuit. First, let us write the equations for mean terms for borrow, or let me write the equations directly. What is borrow? Borrow equation. Here we are getting 1. So what is the equation for borrow? A bar B. So borrow is equal to A bar B. Difference is what? Okay, difference is these two cases we have 1. So it is A bar B. Okay, A bar B plus A B bar is equal to A bar B plus A B bar, which is nothing but A XOR B. Which is nothing but A XOR B. So write the circuit. A B we have A bar B. So this is A bar B, which is nothing but borrow. Okay, so better we write borrow and difference. Okay, borrow. And what is difference? A XOR B. A XOR B. Okay, so this is A XOR B, which is nothing but difference. Okay, which is nothing but difference. So this is the circuit and design of half subtractor. Now let us write for full subtractor, correct? So this is the design of half subtractor. Now let us discuss full subtractor. Okay, so now let us write design full subtractor. So full subtractor, as we know how many inputs we have for full subtractor, let me take it as X, Y, Z. Let me not take ABC because B, borrow, we get confused. So let me take the input variables as X, Y, Z and outputs borrow and difference. Okay, so three inputs, combination 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. Then 1 0 0, 1 0 1, 1 1 0, 1 1 1. Okay. Okay. So now, okay. Now, same as we wrote the truth table of half subtracted. Same, just do normal subtraction, whatever the result we get, for that we write the binary equivalent value. Okay, 0 minus 0 is what? 0. Answer 0. 0 minus 0, we got 0. 0 minus 0 is 0. 0 minus 0 is what? 0. How do we represent 0 in binary? 0, 0. So this is what? Difference. And this is what? Borrow. So 0, 0. 0 minus 0 is what? 0 minus 0 is what? 0. 0 minus 1 is what? 0 minus 1. Minus 1. So how do we represent minus 1 in binary? We have seen the last table we have written. Minus 1 in binary. First write the binary value for 1. Add, take 2's complement. Add 1. So 1, 1. So this is difference and this is borrow. So 1, 1. 0 minus 1. Minus 1. Minus 1 minus 0, minus 1. How do we represent minus 1 in binary? 1, 1, correct? Now, 0 minus 1 is what? Minus 1. Minus 1 minus 1 is what? Minus 2. 0 minus 1 is minus 1. Minus 1 minus 1 is what? Minus 2. How do we represent minus 2 in binary? Same. Take 2's complement of minus 2. First write the binary equivalent value for 2. Binary equivalent value for 2 is 1, 0. Take 1's complement, that is 0, 1. Add 1. 1, 1, 0. 1. 1, 0. What is 1 plus 0? 1. So this is difference and this is borrow. So what is that? Borrow is 1, difference is 0. So binary equivalent value of minus 2 is what? 1, 0. Next, what is 1 minus 0? 1. 1 minus 0? 1. How do we represent 1 in binary? 0, 1. Borrow is 0. Difference is 1. 1 minus 0? 1. 1 minus 1? 0. So, 0, 0. 1 minus 1? 0. 0 minus 0? 0. 1 minus 1? 0. 0 minus 1? Minus 1. Minus 1, this is how we represent. Correct? Yes, so now let us write the equations for this. So write the equation for borrow. What is the equation for borrow? First, let us write the equation for difference. Okay, difference is equal to summation 1, 2, 4, 7. Main terms are 1, 2, 4, 7. Either you can go for KMAP and simplify, same. Sum also we have got the same mean terms, and we know what is the equation we have got for sum. It is xx or yx or z, ax or bx or c. In case of full adder, you can just cross check. Here also for difference we have got the same mean terms. So equation I have to get the same. X, x or y, x or z. Let me prove it again. So difference, let me write the equation. So what is the equation? X bar, y bar, z plus x bar, y, z bar, correct? Plus x, y bar, z bar plus x, y, z. So between these two you take z common. Between these two you take z common. Between these two you take z bar common. So if you take z common, x bar, y bar plus x, y. Between these two you take z bar common. So this will be x bar, y plus x, y bar. Okay, so this will be equal to, what is x bar, y bar plus x, y? It is x, x bar, y plus z bar. What is x bar, y plus x, y bar? It is ax or b, that is xx or y. So what is this? This is just like a, b bar plus a bar, b. What is a, b bar plus a bar, b? A, x or b. So what is a? Z, x or. What is b? X, x or y. So a, x or b. So z, x, x or, which is nothing but x, x or, y, x or, z. So the difference equation is x, x or, y, x or, z. That is the equation for difference. Same way, write for, derive for borrow. You can just, you came up for borrow, you get it. You get the simplified equation fast. But let me do it here. Difference, borrow is equal to what? Summation 1, 2, 3, correct? 7. Summation 1, 2, 3, 7. Write the equation for borrow. It is x bar, y bar, z plus x bar, y, z bar plus x bar, y, z plus x, y, z. You can go for KMAP. Otherwise, you can simplify here also. Okay? So now if you simplify. Okay, between these two, you take x bar, y common. So that I will get z plus z bar, correct? So I will rewrite this as it is, this term. Plus, I'll take what? What is common? X bar common, right? X bar common. So this will be y, z. I'm sorry. One second. X bar, y common. Between these two, you take x bar, y common. So z bar plus z plus x, y, z. So this will be equal to what? X bar, y bar, z. Z plus z bar is 1. So this will be equal to 1 into x bar y is x bar y plus x, y, z. So now, between these two, you take y common. Okay, what happens if you take y common? Let's see. So, or between these two, you take x bar common. If you take x bar common, y bar z plus y you get plus x, y, z. I've taken between these two terms, I've taken x bar common. So this is just like a plus a bar b. What is a plus a bar b? A plus a bar b is a plus b. No, you can expand this. This will be equal to a plus a bar into a plus b. What is a plus a bar? This will be 1. So a plus b you get. So a plus a bar b is a plus b. A plus a bar b is a plus b. A plus a bar b. Y plus y bar z. A plus a bar b is a plus b. That is y plus z. So this will be equal to x bar into y plus z plus x, y, z. Expand. So this will be x bar y plus x bar z plus x, y, z. Further, we can simplify. Yes, we can simplify this further. So between these two, you take z common. Between these two, you take z common. So this will be x bar y plus x. If you take z common, this will be x bar plus xz. Same like a plus a bar b. If you have a bar plus ab, that will be equal to a bar plus b. A bar plus ab is a bar plus b. A bar plus ab is a bar plus b. So this will be equal to x bar plus z. So again expand, again simplify this. X bar y into plus z into x bar plus z. Expand it. X bar y plus x bar z plus z into x bar. Okay, here if I take z common, x bar plus x y, right? So this will be y plus zy. So this is the equation for carry. X bar y plus x bar z plus zy. Correct? X bar y plus x bar z plus zy. So what is the equation we got for borrow? X bar y plus x bar z plus yz. Okay? So some equation is xx or yx or z. Carry equation is x bar y plus x bar z plus yz. Now write the circuit. X, y, z. Or if you want to use two input x or y, you can go for like this. You can write the circuit like this. X, x or y. So this is x, x or y. One x or y. One more input. Give this to an x or y. So that will be equal to x, x or y, x or z. This is nothing but difference. Borrow x bar y. Take x. X bar y. One AND gate. So we have x bar y as output here. Next x bar z. Take the same x bar and z. One more AND gate. So we have x bar z plus y z. So we have y here and z here. So y z. All three you can give it to a single OR gate. Or you want to use two input OR gate. So this will be x bar y plus x bar z. This and this give it to one more OR gate. So this will be x bar y plus x bar z plus y z, which is nothing but borrow. Okay. So this is the circuit of full subtractor. Okay. Okay. So now it is clear. This is the circuit of full subtractor. Difference and borrow. Okay. So this is in the examination, if they ask you to design half subtractor and full subtractor question is very important. Many times it has appeared in the previous year question paper. You have to just write the truth table, write the mean term, simplify it, and then write the equation. Okay. Thank you.